Get out your binoculars because it's time for Heard That Bird. Here's your host, Matt Wilkins.
Hi, welcome to Heard That Bird, the cooperative game show where we ask contestants to identify bird sounds in popular media. Did anyone else hear that? I'm here with a team of birdsong researchers from Nicole Creanza's lab at Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee. Experts, introduce yourselves.
Hi, my name is Nicole Creanza. I'm an assistant professor of biological sciences at Vanderbilt University in Nashville.
Hi, I'm Jimena Leon. I am a third-year PhD candidate at Vanderbilt University.
Hey, my name's Sarah. I'm an undergraduate at Vanderbilt University.
All right, I think y'all are pretty good at IDing birds in the wild, but we'll see how you do with some random clips from pop culture. Have you heard that bird? Is this confident kid correct? Before we answer that question, let's talk about sound spectrograms. A sound spectrogram is a visual representation of frequencies in a recording over time. As you can see here, when my voice gets really high, it's very high on the graph. When my voice gets low, it's lower on the graph. And loud sounds are brighter than quiet sounds. Spectrograms are really useful for identifying birds by their songs, such as this barn swallow. As you can see, the spectrogram visually shows many characteristics of the bird's song that you might not pick up just by listening to it. Now let's get back to clip number one. Here's the same clip as a spectrogram. Is this species A? B? Or C?
Based on the appearance of the birds in the original video, which were kind of large white birds, I was thinking snow geese. Option B in the spectrograms reminds me of feeding birds at the park in my childhood, and those were Canada geese. These are a different type of geese. So I don't think it's B, because they don't look like brown Canada geese.
Yeah, can we hear A again?
Of course.
Yeah, that definitely sounds like a chicken, so I think we can eliminate A and B.
Are we ready to buzz in our final answer?
Yeah, our final answer is C.
Nice job, scientists! There's no fouling you. Now let's take a gander at our rules for the remaining rounds. In addition to IDing the bird species in this clips to come, you should also try to identify the TV, movie, game, or song the clip comes from. So without further ado, here comes clip number two. Have you heard that bird? Is it option A? B? Or C?
Okay, I want to rule out A and B because they have more syllables, which are basically bursts of sound separated by silence. In the source clip, we just heard one long noise.
I agree.
I also agree.
Okay, final answer C? Do we know the species?
Yeah, I think so. This one's fun because I can tell that the visualization in the clip doesn't match the call. So the clip looks like a bald eagle, which I think is A, but the audio sounds like a red-tailed hawk.
Intriguing. So does anyone know the source of the clip?
The Colbert Report?
Well done! The bird you heard was indeed a red-tailed hawk with an image of a bald eagle from the Colbert Report. This is a pretty common switcheroo on TV. But the next time our viewers hear a hawk instead of an eagle, they won't be quite so gullible. All right, let's take a flight to our next clip.
I feel confident about the bird. I'm not sure I know the clip, the movie clip that it comes from, though.
I think it might be from the new Jumanji movie.
There's a lot going on in that clip, so here is the part we're focusing on. Is that A? B? Or C?
I saw the old Jumanji. I remember there's a lot of jungle scenes. I haven't seen the new one. But I know that a lot of times in movies you hear a kookaburra sound when they're trying to give the vibe of a jungle, even though they live in Australia and not in a lot of other jungles.
Okay, so you seem confident it's a kookaburra. But which spectrogram shows this? Let's play them again.
option A, I remember also from my childhood, it sounds like a peacock, which they were feral peacocks growing up around my school in Florida. And so I'm familiar with those sounds. I think it sounds like Minnie Mouse crying for help. So I don't think it's A.
That's such a good way to remember that. Yeah, I think B sounds the most like the clip.
Okay, let's lock in our answer. B from Jumanji.
Nicely done. Though it might sound like a monkey, what you heard was in fact a bird. As Nicole said, kookaburras are often featured in establishing shots of rainforests and TV and movies set in South America and Africa, but they're native to Australia. Okay, let's swoop on over to our next clip.
But who's it from?
Susan Flincher.
What does she say?
Well, prepare yourself for the worst.
Okay, that clip happened right at the beginning, so you may have missed it. Here it is, just the bird. Is that option A? B? Or C?
So I think the clip sounds like it has a trill or a rattle, which is just a rapidly repeated element. But so I think it is probably B.
I agree.
And the actress looks like Professor McGonagall from Harry Potter, but I don't think the clip is from Harry Potter.
Nice, good job identifying Maggie Smith.
I don't know what it is, but based on the spectrogram, B looks pretty similar to the clip.
I think it's kind of thrush-sized based on the vocalization.
Okay, let's lock in spectrogram B, and do you know the source of the clip?
I'm still not sure what the clip is from.
Yeah, I think the bird is a magpie, but I don't know where the clip is from.
All right, let's find out. Caw-caw! The bird you heard was in fact B, a Eurasian magpie from the TV drama Downton Abbey. Fun fact for you Anglophiles, magpies are often used in establishing shots of TV and movies shot in the UK. Let's flap over to the next challenge. All right, there are a couple of sounds in that scene, so we're gonna focus on just this one. Is that A? B? Or C?
Okay, I want to eliminate B. Both A and C have a trill sound at the end, which I heard in the source clip.
I agree. I think B is an American robin. I have a little mnemonic device, like a little phrase that I use to remember the robin song, and it's cheer up, cheerily. And I heard that in B.
Yeah, so I agree with that. I think we can definitely eliminate B. And I think we can also eliminate C that has that high-pitched, almost echoey sound to it.
All right, let's lock in A then for the final answer. And I believe it's the hermit thrush.
Okay, final answer A. Let's see if you got it right. Ding, ding, ding. The bird you heard was a hermit thrush from the video game Horizon Zero Dawn. These options were challenging because we gave you two really similar species, so nice work. Let's flap our way over to the next clip. Let's play just the bird song again. Is that option A? B? Or C?
Okay, so my first thought is to eliminate B just because there is a trill. So as a reminder, it's a repetition of an element, a rapid repetition of an element. So I think we can eliminate B.
I agree, let's eliminate B.
And I think the clip is similar to A. The length of the bird song is longer, but in C, the sound is shorter. A also has more modulation in the frequency. And by that, I mean when you look at the spectrogram, you can see the lines moving up and down a lot.
You can also see that the spacing in the spectrogram of the clip looks more like A to me.
And I know the song is by the Beatles, but I'm not sure which song.
Yeah, I think the song is Blackbird by the Beatles, and I think that the bird is also a blackbird, so I'm glad they did the correct bird there.
So we think we know the bird species and the source. Were you right? Nicely done. A bird you might hear singing in the dead of night. Fun evolution fact, red-winged blackbirds are the only one of these three that is actually in the family blackbirds, Icteridae. The other two are thrushes. On that note, let's wing it to the next question. Let's play the clip again and listen to all three options. Is it A? B? Or C?
I think it's B, because the sound is low frequency. And it's sort of eerie and sustained, which reminds me of the mourning dove. But I definitely want to hear what the others think.
Yeah, I agree with you on the eeriness. But I think that the bird in the clip was a loon. And B to me sounded like a dove. So C was what I was leaning toward. But there's something else in C that's a little higher pitched that I couldn't quite put my finger on.
Yeah, would you mind playing B and C again?
Sure thing.
Yeah, I think there's a couple things going on in C. I think there's a higher pitched sound that might be a cricket and then maybe a loon at lower frequencies.
And what's the clip? I recognize it from TikTok, but I forget the rapper's name.
You're right. It's option C, the loon. This song is by Doja Cat. Fun fact, you might hear the loon in many hip hop songs because the producer Y2K uses the loon call as his tag. You might even call his music Looney Tunes. Sorry, I'll show myself out. And now for our last clip. Here's the clip again with the bird song enhanced. Is that A? B? Or C?
I've tried to figure this one out before because I know the song, but I'm not sure what bird it is. When I listen to A and B, it doesn't sound like the clip, I don't think. There's kind of rapid delivery, and C sounded most like it, I think, but I don't know. It doesn't sound exactly the same to me either.
Yeah, I agree. I think looking at C, it has a similar number of syllables compared to the source clip, whereas the others two do not.
Yeah, the C sounded like a warbler to me. I've listened to these songs before in nature, but in the actual song, it sounds a little bit different. Like, I'm not sure if they remixed it or played it.
Yeah, I was actually wondering the same thing. This one is pretty hard.
Okay, so apparently we're thinking warbler and option C, is that right?
I think so, yeah. Let's go with C.
And do you all know what the source is?
Exile by Taylor Swift.
That was a softball because we all know that Nicole's a Swiftie. As far as the ID, we actually don't know. I reached out to tons of people about this clip from the Czech Republic to California. I even reached out to Taylor Swift's sound mixers and didn't get a response. In the end, it was a researcher in Utah who finally proposed Townsend's Warbler. And that's our show. Thanks so much to the Creanza Lab for playing our first episode of Heard That Bird. If you liked this, please like and subscribe. And we encourage you to check out the Merlin app, link in the description. It's a free app that lets you see spectrograms and ID birds in real time. This video supports a free galactic polymath lesson, so if you want to have students play along with the scientists, check out that link in the description as well. Remember, birds do more than inspire artists. They spread seeds and keep our ecosystems healthy. So get outside and start listening. Can you ID a bird from our show today?